Hi, I'm Alyssa Farrell, and I lead SAS's industry market strategy for healthcare and life sciences. One of the most pressing issues that I hear from leaders today is how to efficiently capture the most value from your data, enabling your teams to accelerate corporate priorities. I recently had the opportunity to interview Wayne Fillon Matthews, the global lead for enterprise strategy and architecture at AstraZeneca. He's bringing some new approaches to this complex task, including a crystal ball on AI and Gen AI, and I think his insights are worth sharing again. Listen in to our conversation, and I'll rejoin afterwards with more information. The industry of health and life sciences is one that I am personally very passionate about. Ensuring that medical products are safe and effective requires complex data analytics spanning countries, patients, and years. SAS is proud of our partnership with leading health and pharma companies to accelerate the delivery of life-saving therapeutics around the world. To speak more about why productivity matters more than ever now in life sciences, I'd like to welcome AstraZeneca's Global Head of Enterprise Architecture, Wayne Fillon Matthews. Hey, good. Wayne, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for the invite. Really glad to be here.
Awesome. Welcome to SAS Innovate.
Thank you.
So AstraZeneca may be a household name to some, but may be new to others. Can you tell us a little bit about the primary therapeutic areas that your company is focused on?
Yeah, and there's a lot of them, and they're growing consistently. Our main focus areas from a therapeutic perspective are oncology, so our oncology therapeutics to serve those patients in the oncology division is growing. We also basically do therapeutics around cardiovascular, specifically around renal and metabolism in terms of the focus around those therapeutics as well. We're also heavily focused on respiratory as a key therapeutic. Equally as important as part of our Alexion acquisition a couple of years ago on rare disease. So just a couple of areas of our therapeutic areas that are serving both the needs of our patients today and the needs of our patients tomorrow.
It's a big portfolio that you're managing.
Very big.
So SAS and AstraZeneca have been partnering for many years, but recently it's expanded to SAS VIA.
Yes.
So can you tell us more about your aspirations for that partnership and for VIA for your teams?
Yeah, I think it's been mentioned throughout the sessions today, which is productivity and those elements that we're looking to do as we increase our scientists to meet those demands from a patient outcome perspective. Productivity is number one. I'd also say trust in the platform specifically. When you look at the integration of AI and the generative models that we've talked about today, the ability to trust the platform is equally as important to the productivity elements. So I think that with data lineage that sits across those platforms has been one of the reasons why we've selected SAS VIA. I also said to Brian recently, which is every time that I think of a new idea in the role that I do, SAS has already basically thought about it, and basically you've seen some of those announcements today, so thank you for doing that. Yeah. Saves me a lot of work.
Well, you know, keep bringing us the challenges as well. So you mentioned productivity. Why is that mattering right now at AstraZeneca, given the portfolio that you're trying to manage?
Yeah, and it's a huge portfolio. And if you think of drug development, normally bringing a single drug to market can take anywhere between sort of, you know, 6 to 10 years plus. We have a bold ambition to bring 20 new therapeutics to market, 20 new medicines by 2030. So, you know, making sure that we have those trusted partners, consolidating some of that ecosystem down to make it simpler is just as important to the scientific work that takes place to develop those therapeutics from early science all the way through to delivery of that medicine to our patients.
That's an ambitious goal.
It is. Very ambitious.
Very ambitious. It's like tomorrow, 2030.
Literally. It's like every day I wake up thinking it's getting closer.
Yeah. Wayne, you've had a technology leadership career that has spanned like financial services, AI and tech leadership, now pharma. Is there something that you learned early in your career that you still use today?
Yeah, and I've been doing this for 38 years, so a long time, and I'm feeling old, and I look at Dr. Goodnight, and I'm not as sprightly as Dr. Goodnight, and I hope I am when I spend another 10 years doing this. But I think the key for me, and it sounds a little bit cliche, and we've all heard the statement of putting customers in an in our case, patients at the center of the decision making. But I wish I knew when I started my career in banking, sort of in my early 20s, that I really understood what that meant by putting customers and patients first. Ultimately drives those outcomes that we've talked about, specifically to make better decisions in the organization.
It's really good advice. Last question. We've talked about generative AI, AI, kind of looking out over the horizon in a tech leadership position. Where do you see some areas of application that the business leaders should consider?
Yeah, well, it's interesting, even Marilena's comment earlier, which is the number one question I get asked in the roles that I've done, even my time at Microsoft and at Dell and various other roles that I've done over the 38 years, is what is your AI strategy? And I'm sure people in the audience have also been asked, what is your AI strategy? And I'll be honest with you, I don't think there is an AI strategy. There is a business strategy that is infused with AI that ultimately, when you map that to patient outcomes, that the opportunity becomes, you know, existential in terms of basically how you utilize it. When I think of areas in pharmaceutical, you know, supply chain optimization, medical and clinical trial optimization for the betterment of our patients, you know, identification of new medicines and modalities. These are just some of the opportunities and use cases that we're exploring, investigating to speed up basically better outcomes for our patients.
Wayne, thank you so much for your time and you're sharing your insights with the group. Really appreciate it. No, thanks for being
thank
here.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Keeping patients at the heart of our decision-making, focusing AI on the business problem, not just the technology, these are incredible insights. And thanks again to Wayne and the entire team at AstraZeneca who are working to bring new therapies to all of us each day. For more information on SAS in life sciences, head over to our website or listen to our latest podcast on the Health Pulse. We're ready to help accelerate your next breakthrough.